Hey guys, welcome back. You are watching with Baywatch, and in this video we will talk about this massive event going on. The event name is the Border Mineral Vein Attack. Look, current stage battle stage will end after 9 hours. Okay, as you can see, a four types of mineral vein border attack is available. Look, first is this is ultimate and advanced. Look, okay, as you can see here, this is advanced and fighting 262 current occupation of this kingdom, and kingdom this vein belong to also 262. This one is 403, and we have fighting basic, and this is 10 1023, and we have captured that. The fight is over because we have destroyed their vein. And this one is 1431, so this one is still in fighting. The fight is over, we cannot join. Look, right, both three are fighting, so we can join. For example, if we port in this basic one, and that vein belongs to us, no need to recall your troops. Wherever your marches are, your troops will suddenly come back, and you will be ported into this vein event. Well, when you attack on this is similar to the Dragon campaign event, but somehow this is not, because their losses will be counted. But as you can see here, there is a building next to me, right? If I use to attack, my troops will be wounded instead of dying. Look, I don't know if I don't know which color belong to us. Somehow they will give us blue, so somehow they will give us red. So this one is from our kingdom, so basically we have now. So guys, basically we have this blue, those blue, whatever the buffs, the building, whatever buffs gives might it. For example, now cavalry damage 5%. I haven't get this building, but it's belong to my kingdom. That's why my percentage is higher. My HP will be 5% higher, like so on. Right now it's red. So basically there are several ways to get point. Right now this is sacred portal 403, and they are destroying us in 4 hours and 50 minutes. The destruction will be completed, and when you tap on this, this will show you the fight will over. It means that we have destroyed, right? So basically several ways to get points. For example, when you equip this building, you will get randomly points. Okay, and you have just not in and out. There will be no timer on this. You have to just send 2 to 3 troops, then wait, and as long as they will stay, as much as points you can get. Now for example, they are destroying our portal, so they are continuously getting points, right? If I use to attack on this castle, right, that is knight, and I will get points, right? Killings give, oh look, this is, she got 1G kills, that's massive. Well, okay, attacking is points, railing, occupying sacred portal gives points, even killing reinforcements gives you points. Okay guys, so when my shield will be dropped, and then they can attack me, and if I lose, it means that simply that I need to, my troops will be died. But until my hospital capacity doesn't get full, my troops won't die, right? My troops will stay. So for example, now I am setting continuously rallies on my own kingdom, right? So my shield is basically dropped, and I need few troops. Look, okay, I have very few troops at home now, so I am out of danger. If someone gonna attack me, I am just gonna chill, right? Now I am scouting, as you can see. So basically, I'm telling you how to get points and how to stay safe, right? If you are a bigger power, but still your stars are not that massive, so better you do what? For example, you need a form with a decent percentage or a castle that is like me. I have 23 billion power, right? And I can easily hide my troops, right? So if I can easily hide my troops, that means that if I'll get attack, I won't get much damage, right? My troops will be wounded and I can cover it back easily. So find castle like me and you can reinforce, and then I will attack. Look, my name is on the screen, Baywatch from Kingdom 403. And now I have that cross bending boss also, HP for sages. Look, so look, I used to scout, but this doesn't give me the scout report. It means that there is no troops guardian there, right? So I can continue my attack and I can achieve some points also. It's okay, right? So yes. And also there is a tip: if you want to get some kills too, then you send dragon with every morph, so dragon can kill a little bit. Look, my peace shield is dropped and I'll have same stuff, right? Occupying guild buildings will find sacred portal. Attacking, occupying, destroying, defending also gives points. Sharing, you can also share. If I'll send here 50k troops for stance, right? So someone attacks, my troops will be wounded and attacker troops will be also wounded. Remember that, right? And look, so basically that's how you can play this event. But if I'll click on this go home, my troops will be suddenly come back and my castle will be out, right? So let's have a look at rewards. So personal points when reached is giving a lot of rewards, good rewards. Look at experience, prestige badges, speed ups, fine iron, evolution stones, like everything you desire for, right? Even holy badges, there will be angel wings too. Okay, VIP points also. Look, at maximum you can with 20k points, and 20k points you can earn easily, no worries. You can find some form also. Okay, now let's have a look at score ranking. But one thing guys, you need to be careful and be very smart, right? You just don't be stupid, right? Because you don't know how massacre and massive brutal attacks, brutal stats guys putting here. Like we are here four kingdoms, right? So if you easily think that looks like SP1 is our kingdom is going to rally on that, but let's see what happens. If they rally and call in kingdom chat, so I'll probably join, and this one will also be the part of video, but in the battle recording, not on this guide section. You have to be attentive, be smart, do not be stupid, because massive stats will be porting here and you will be dusted. Even if you are a 300 million power P6 castle with P6 troops also, T12s, T13 also, if you are not just enough tight, you will be busted so hard. Guys will be massive, so be smart while playing this event. Hide all your troops. If you can't hide, do not drop your bubble. Try to reinforcement someone and get points, right? Or just play like in and out. Like my castle is here. If someone just in and hit, it's up to his luck. Even he can check by a flash if I'm reinforcement or not. If I'm reinforced, you can check by alliance power and something else. So you can imagine, if you can win, go ahead. If you can't, then push yourself back and go home and tap to this go home button and you will be ported home, right? And then after 5 minutes you can enter again and play hide and seek game. So let's have a look at score ranking. So look, number of points guys have. So it's almost giving a okay, it's a brutal win over here. Look, at least I will score, okay, 150. Top guys will receive rewards tomorrow, and rewards are nice basically. And well, one thing more, what is the basic reason for the farmers or a middle order players that used to play Border Mineral Vein event? Is that you can get holy badges, like everything that is used in refogging, for excellent equipments like blueprints and other stuff. Look, if we have this, if we click on this store in the traveling merchant, here is where is mineral vein store. I have this points a lost mineral vein event. So basically this is mineral vein gather code. It needs 1000 points in one vein to get this, and you can gather forever. After, for your understanding, before KVK you can say, or after AVK, like this event is repeated twice in a month, right? And when this event is ongoing, on Sunday there will be a gathering stage. There you can also tag people, but you cannot occupy buildings and fight on the portals, right? Then there will be some like resource plots, but there will be also food, wood, and mithril and iron. But there will be angel wings, research stones, obsidians, angel wings, holy badges, and also blueprints, except helmet, but maybe helmets also. And you can also buying, look, someone scouted our castle, so you can buy this cord and you can gather, and you can fog equipments, and you can build archangels, and you can be strong, right? For now I am defending, and I believe I will have some points too. Maybe not. Let's have a look. Look, someone is attacking on my fort. Fort means that, holy shit, they have got this. Look, someone is railing on me, but railing is just a flash, right? They are scouting. This one scouts. Okay. Look, they attacked on my fort, and my troops also get wounded. And this attacker from Air Alliance, someone Taiwan or somehow, got decent stats also. Look, his troops also get wounded, right? So if we have a look, this is current king of 262. I got it back, right? And I have low troops there, so probably he will be looking for points. I have points 1, right? But sometimes if I kept defending, I will get points for sure, right? So guys, this video is basically for the guys who doesn't know about this event. And also we will shoot a video for Sunday, that will be gathering stage. And also follow the instructions, play smart, play decent, and get stronger. And do not forget to subscribe. And also woke up at the reset, because in the early hours you can find better things for your as refogging material for your equipments, right? Angel wings, because if you will just woke up early, and you will port in gathering stage, and you can gather easily. Like if you gathering with full march, your time will be shorter, like 17 minutes. But if you will gathering like level 3 plot with four blueprints, like, so it will cause you 1 hour. But if you will gathering with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 troops, like couple troops with a very tiny march on gathering plot level 4 with 6 blueprints, so it will cause you 2 hours, and 2 hours are enough. You can sleep also, and your shield will not be dropped. So kept scouting, whatever, or this video I put in to show you how to play this event. And stay tuned. Thanks for support, thanks for watching. Do not forget to subscribe. And if if we have something miss and you want to ask, you can also blow the comment section. We will appreciate that.